Hey, what's up, guys? Tukey here, back again, and today I'm going to go over how to add the Seattle Kraken into a modern-day FHM 7 save. A lot of you have asked me about this, so I figured, hey, why not make the video to talk all about it? And of course, if you want to check out my journey with the Seattle Kraken, you can do so on this channel. The playlist is easy enough to find as we look to take a team from expansion into a dynasty. So obviously, when it comes to the settings in terms of setting everything up, for the most part, all of the beginning stuff is up to you, obviously, whatever you want to name the file. The key here, for the sake of this, I'd say right now, is at least avoid the real start. You can start as a real GM if you want to. Again, most of that is completely up to you. Another thing I'd add here as well, when it comes to the amount of leagues that you have active, I highly recommend you only have leagues active that you're actually going to participate in. Turning these off doesn't mean that those leagues don't exist within the save. It just means what leagues, of course, you are able to jump to. If you only want to play in the NHL, there is no reason to have these other leagues active. Just hit deselect all. If you want to do kind of a world tour, I highly recommend just kind of selecting the leagues that you ideally want to go to. Obviously, too, you can have everything active and take a job anywhere, but obviously, again, it will put more strain on your PC. So aside from that, I clicked past it, but challenge mode is completely up to you. You get to your manager settings, and the key thing that you're going to want to do here, or at least keep in mind, July 1st is the start date that we're going to care about. For the sake of showing you how to set this up, we are going to go with July 1st. It doesn't matter that we're starting off as unemployed, so we can just continue on here. Same thing for here. Doesn't really matter. You can do all that, of course, as you want to. For the sake of this video, though, none of those stats matter. Okay, so again, as mentioned, July 1st is the start date that you're going to care about. Now, I will say, if you want an accurate representation of when Seattle will be joining the league, you are going to have to sim to July 1st, 2021 to be able to add them in at the proper time instead of here on July 1st, 2020 when you first start a save file. The big thing here, manager options, make sure you're on commissioner mode. This allows you to edit everything, basically from player contracts to whatever. You'll hit NHL, and actually you won't hit NHL. You will go down to, bear with me here, it's been a little bit since I've done this. Yeah, you will go down to NHL, and you'll go down to edit. It confused me with the active drafts. And again, here, you can add literally anything you want to. You can change the trophies. You can change the average of goals per game between the two teams. Literally all of this is customizable. Here's where you can change the rules as well throughout the league. And of course, you can also change the league structure. And this is where we start to pay attention, because of course, we have the expansion draft as well. And obviously here is where you can set up the different settings to say, okay, here's where the draft date is. Here's the number of rounds. So obviously, if you're doing this, you're going to want to say 30 teams, not 31, and likely exclude the Vegas Golden Knights down here at the bottom, because, of course, in real life, they are not going to be affected by the Seattle expansion. You can set up the amount of players that the teams have to protect by default. It's at 1 goalie, 3 defensemen, 7 forwards, which is accurate, if I'm not mistaken. Of course, the one thing that you're going to want to be able to do as well is say the max player lost per team is 1, not 50. Because that means you'd be able to take more than one player off of each team. So this number right here is very important. You're going to want to make sure that that is at 1. Aside from that, honestly, you pretty much don't have to do all that much else. You also have the option to say that no movement clauses must be protected. I highly recommend that as well for a realistic setup here. So what you're going to want to do for this particular setup here is, of course, go down to the divisions. Your first step for adding Seattle, not your foist step. I don't know what a foist step is, but obviously move the Coyotes, click move to, and get them over to the Central Division, because that's what's going to be happening in real life. And then for the Pacific Division, you're going to hit add team. And pretty much all you have to do, if I'm not mistaken, you go over, just type in Seattle and Kraken. Oops, keyboard's acting up, but there you go, Seattle Kraken. An abbreviation of whatever you want it to be, and you're pretty much good to go. Now you can go back over to expansion draft, click draft for the Kraken. Again, make sure you are excluding the Vegas Golden Knights. Get these settings the way you want them set up. You're going to hit generate draft. Only got to hit it once, and that sets you up for the very next day, July 2nd. Of course, go back over to structure, and from there, you're going to want to hit generate schedule. That is your last step. Again, after changing the structure, you may have to rebuild the schedule. So that's pretty much it. You go over, you add in the Seattle Kraken here. Pretty straightforward. Again, move the Coyotes over to the Central. Go back over to expansion draft. Again, draft, set up all your settings, hit generate draft, and then go back over and hit generate schedule. And with that, you are basically good to go. The Kraken are now a thing in the league. It's pretty straightforward. And again, now we go over to Seattle, and by default, it adds in their logo. If you want to change certain things about the colors, all you have to do is when you hit the Kraken, go down, again, still in commissioner mode, hit edit, and that'll bring you to the team edit page, where from here you do have to update some things. Obviously, you want to take them out of Fort Worth. You can change the primary colors. It's easy enough to find the proper color codes for Seattle by just, you know, Google searching Seattle Kraken color codes. And you can change pretty much everything else that you want to change from there. But all in all, pretty straightforward. Like I said, keep in mind, Sim to 2021. And that pretty much covers it in terms of how to get Seattle into the league. Again, the big thing to keep in mind here is that the list of events is in a little bit of a different order compared to real life, where if you'll notice here, typically the draft is after the beginning of free agency as well. So keep that in mind as you get into that 2021 expansion draft and, of course, the entry draft and free agency. There's a bit of a different order of operations that just made a little bit more sense for the developers to take. But all things considered, that should do it. If you have any questions, if you think I missed something, let me know. Any other FHM questions in general, let me know. I'll try to get back to you as best I can. But that is how to add the Seattle Kraken into FHM 7. Let me know how those save files go, and let me know if you can turn the Kraken into a bigger dynasty than I happen to do. Again, right here on this channel.